This is the Erez crossing just outside the Gaza Strip. Journalists and humanitarian aid finally getting a chance to go in there. But good news, for the past 12 hours, that ceasefire has held.
Celebrations in the Middle East, thousands parading through the streets, honking, whistling, shouting from the rooftops. They're swapping airstrikes and rockets for fireworks. That is Hamas and Israel agreed overnight to what Hamas confirmed was a mutual and simultaneous ceasefire agreement reached in the Gaza Strip. At least 260 Palestinians killed in the West Bank and Gaza, over 3,300 wounded. And Israel, 12 killed and about 350 wounded. The agreement following days of pressure from world leaders. President Biden had 6 calls with Israel's prime minister on Wednesday demanding a de-escalation today.
I believe the Palestinians and Israelis equally deserve to live safely and securely and to enjoy equal measures of freedom, prosperity, and democracy.
More than 70,000 in Gaza bombed out of their homes as this morning they continue to bury their dead. 11-year-old Dima Isala, one of the last victims of this conflict. Her mother, Dunya, clutching the girl's backpack containing her daughter's toys, saying she was afraid of the bombings. One of the last rockets from Gaza destroying Sigal Arieli's home. She was in her bomb shelter, her son inside the house.
So I was in the shelter, he was in the house.
How long did it take for you to realize that he's okay? And what were you thinking in those moments?
2 seconds. Okay. I pushed the door out, I opened. He said, "Mom, I'm fine. Calm down, take a deep breath."
What's that feeling like?
Wow, he's okay, really. No other words.
A new push to get people back to work with cash. As COVID cases drop sharply and more restrictions are lifted, many businesses are facing a new problem. They say unemployment benefits from the federal government are working against them.
Well, some people are looking for work and some people are not.
In response, Colorado is now offering people up to $1,600 to forego unemployment benefits and return to work full-time. Connecticut and Arizona are also planning to give out bonuses to people who go back to work. It comes as more states offer cash prizes to get more people vaccinated. In New York City, the governor announced lottery scratch tickets for people who are vaccinated with a $5 million top prize.
Everybody wins. You have a 1 in 9 chance of winning the lottery, but you get the vaccine and you win.
President Biden has set a new goal of getting 70% of adults vaccinated with at least one shot by July 4th. But now that percentage is still under 50%, and vaccination rates are slowing down.